Hutsi and welcome. Welcome to this new episode of Inno Update. My name is Maarten Kos and Inno Update is all about corporate innovation. And today's topic is getting kicked by a simple box. And if you look at the nine topics of innovation, one of the most important topic are the resources. The resources, how to support your employees with innovation. You can think about money, time, but one of the resources you can use is the Adobe Kickbox. Well, as the name says, it's developed by Adobe by a guy called Mark Randall. And Mark was asked by the board of directors, Mark, how can we make sure that the people who have ideas within Adobe can create the ideas and create products or services? Because there were a lot of ideas, but they didn't bubble up to the surface within Adobe. And Mark created a box which contained a booklet, a kind of kickbook, which has all the phases of the innovation process. And this box was delivered to employees, and it was a kind of gamification with levels of innovation. They even got a credit card with some budget to do experiments. And it was a really successful program within Adobe. A lot of new ideas were turned into actual products or services. And then an amazing thing happened, because Mark open sourced the Adobe Kickbox. So every organization in the world could download the stuff and the learnings from Mark, and he created a community of people who were using the Adobe Kickbox. At that time, it was 2015, I guess, I was working at Rabobank and I was responsible for accelerating the innovation culture within our organization. And one of the things I organized was masterclasses, where I invited people who wanted to learn about innovation and talk about innovation to them. And it was very successful, but it was hard to scale. It was only 20 people each time. So it was a good program, but we couldn't scale it within the organization. We also had an internal accelerator program where we had internal startup teams, and these people, these employees who had their own startup, also had to learn lean startup methodology. And Kees van Nuenen was one of the coaches at that time we hired to learn, to coach these teams. And he talked about, Maarten, did you look at the Innovation Kickbox? And when I looked at it, I said, okay, this could be a great program, not only for our startups, internal startups, but also to replace the masterclasses we had. So I talked about the program and I set a challenge within the organization to name this new program. And people came up with the name Innovate, to help our employees. And I introduced the program just as I introduced a lot of the things I did in Rabobank as an experiment. Testing it as a do-it-yourself innovation tool. Because I thought, okay, we could send these boxes to people, we have an online environment, and then the people could do it all by themselves. And it was a complete failure. It didn't work out at all, because people weren't motivated enough to do it all by themselves. Then in the next sprint, we organized a launch party where people could meet each other and maybe help each other and stimulate each other. That went a little bit better, but we did encounter that the people who were doing it in teams were much more successful than the people who did it all by themselves. So within the next sprint, we said, okay, you have to make a team. So we had people with different IDs. We also had people who didn't have an ID who could join up with people. We have an ID marketplace where people could share IDs. And each sprint, we added something to it. Sometimes it were coaches to help people more, to instead of giving them money, giving their designers. So we had a lot of changes each sprint we did it. And then Koen Bosma came and he did a great uplift of the professionalizing the Innovate program, the Kickbox program. And he added much more lean startup methodology. He really improved the online website. And finally, and also, of course, we did some changes in the look and feel, and we each time improved it with each sprint. And now it's completely integrated and it's a part of the way of how to accelerate innovation within the Rabobank organization. So That's how we did it within RainbowBank. And if you want to look at the Adobe Kickbox about the process, it's a really simple process how to learn innovation for your employees. It started out with the why. Why do you want to be an innovator? Why is it important to you? What are your ambition? So that's the first step you need to discover. And then the next level is all about the problem. Because most of the people have an idea, but does it really solve a problem? So, and is it a problem which is worth solving? If you succeed that level, then you come to the solution. Do you create a solution which is really going to be adapted by customers? You create personas, you listen to consumers, but also watch consumers, do tests, create a minimal viable product. And if you succeed in that level, then you come to the concept phase, where you define the concept, but also your vision for the next step and the business model of how you're going to earn some money. And the last phase of the red kickbox is all about convincing, because you are an employee within a corporation. So you need to convince your idea to the board or to a guy who wants to sponsor you and want to adapt the idea. And if you look at these phases, they are very similar to the seven phases of the innovation process. And if you want to learn more about the seven phases, check out my episode at Inno Update of these phases. I will put it also in the show notes of this episode. The companies who are using Adobe Kickbox are, of course, Adobe. I think Swisscom is a very good example, but also Procter & Gamble, MasterCard. And you find online a lot of the learnings of these companies, how they use it. Of course, at RainbowBank we used it, but not only commercial companies, also the United Nations and the Bill Gates Foundation all used the Adobe Kickbox or are still using it. I think it's a very good method to get started in helping your employees do it. And if you want to implement it within your organization, I think it really helps to get faster from an idea to a minimal viable product. And do it as an experiment. Test it yourself, because you need to adapt the kickbox strategy into your own culture. There's a lot of resources already. You can download it, you can test it, and then change it to your culture and to your wishes you want to do. And there are more and more consultants who can help. But you can start with the kickbox.org website, where you can download the stuff. If you want help, if you don't have the resources to implement it yourself, if you don't have internships or trainees who can help you with that, you can also go to a company called, for example, getkickbox.com. These are guys from the Swisscom organization. They did a really good job at their own organization, but also at other Swiss organizations. And they can help you. They can help you. They have the materials. They have an online website which you can make tailor-made for you, can get your own logo. And within a couple of weeks, you are ready to go within your organization. So I hope you like this episode of InnoVa Update. In the meantime, keep innovating.